Well, from where we sit, Australian politics can be bewildering at times, not least just a week or so ago when the sitting, well, minority government had to watch opposition parties band together to pass a bill it certainly didn't want. The medical evacuations bill allows asylum seekers to be evacuated from Australia's offshore detention centres, remember Nauru and Manus Island, for expert care. Now, the new independent MP, Dr. Kerryn Phelps, was the driving force behind it. And when I spoke to her earlier today, I asked whether this was a softening in Australia's hardline stance on the issue of boat people.
It's been reported as a softening of the hardline stance, but it's not. I mean, you can still have strong borders, but a humane approach to people seeking asylum. And that's what this legislation seeks to do. There were people who were not getting the care that they needed in a timely way because medical advice was not being followed. And in the hundreds of cases that were sent to the courts, in every case, the doctor's advice was followed. And so there was no point to all of this obstruction. And so what I sought to do when I was elected to Parliament just in October of last year was to do what I could, using the fact that it was now a minority government, to change the approach that Australia had without affecting national security, because it's very important to Australians that we don't see people trying to get onto boats and risking their lives and indeed losing their lives by drowning at sea.
Right.
So it was important to make sure that there's a very clear message that we don't want people getting on boats, but that we also can take a humane approach to medical care.
That's interesting. So the Labor Party has come out, what maintains its stance against or backs offshore detention centres. Do you also support that current policy?
It's not appropriate or humane for people to be confined in offshore detention indefinitely. Now, we have a cohort of just over 1,000 people who are Australia's responsibility, who are seeking asylum or have been found to be refugees on Manus Island and Nauru, just over 1,000 people. Now, what we need to do is to fast-track a regional resettlement option. Now, both of the major parties here in Australia have, and I'm an independent, but both of the major parties in Australia have a policy of not allowing anyone who tries to get here by boat to resettle in Australia. And so that means that we have to look to countries like the US, New Zealand, and other countries in the region to find permanent resettlement options for these people so that they can live in freedom and in safety.
But of course, Australia will not accept New Zealand's offer to take 150 of these, well, potential refugees. Why is that so staunch, that opposition?
It's quite frustrating, really, because New Zealand did make a generous offer, I believe, initially under Prime Minister Key and maintained through Prime Minister Ardern to Australia to take 150 refugees per year from Manus Island and Nauru. But Australia has not accepted that offer, and that's been under the last two Prime Ministers. And the reason for that is that because there is a system or an agreement between Australia and New Zealand of free travel between Australia and New Zealand, that people who are seeking asylum will use the resettlement option in New Zealand as a backdoor way of getting into Australia. So the sticking point has been around whether these people should have a special kind of passport or visa that only allows them to go to New Zealand but not to come to Australia.
Is this an area where you could use your position on the crossbenches to try and make some further progress in terms of law changes in this area?
I think we need to take a regional approach to this, and obviously the generous New Zealand offer was very welcome. What we also need to do is to look at whether more people can be resettled in the US. There've already been about 500 people resettled in the United States. Originally, Prime Minister Malcolm Turnbull arranged with President Barack Obama back in 2016 to settle 1,250 people.
And Donald Trump wasn't too happy about that, was he?
No, he wasn't. But Prime Minister Turnbull at the time reassured Donald Trump that the people who were on Manus Island and Nauru at that time had been there under supervision for 3 years, and that Australia knew everything about those people and that they had been screened for security risk and so forth. And so that deal did in fact go ahead, at least in part. But what we have now is about 1,080 people who remain on Manus Island and Nauru who still need to have a permanent resettlement option so that they can get on with their lives.
I see Bill Shorten has came out pretty quickly to say he would support potentially support Scott Morrison's idea of a some sort of a medical facility on Christmas Island. But what I'm detecting also from yourself here is that the idea of asylum seekers, if they get on a boat, ever coming to Australia, that's a no-go zone in terms of the election, in terms of politics. It's almost like it's out of bounds. Is that right?
It's a very politically sensitive issue. Of course, nobody's really talking much about the tens of thousands of people who are arriving by plane on tourist visas and then seeking asylum. And so it's all focused, the attention's all focused on stopping people getting on boats and trying to come to Australia. The idea about Christmas Island was a technicality, because the legislation said that that if people were unable to get the care that they needed to receive on Manus Island and Nauru, that they should come to Australia if they had the recommendation of two doctors who made the case that these people couldn't be treated there. And of course, the bright idea was that because Christmas Island is technically Australian territory, it's not Australian mainland, that people would go there. And then, of course, the president of the Shire Council on Christmas Island said, what are they coming here for? Our medical services are no better than on Manus Island and Nauru. And indeed, the people on Christmas Island have to be transferred down to Perth in Western Australia because they've got no obstetric service, no surgical service and no psychiatric service.
Just one last question, because we're running short of time, but I wonder, your seat, Wentworth, Bondi, very familiar to many New Zealanders. I'm sure there are plenty of expat Kiwis living there. I wonder, again, given your interesting position on the crossbenches and the power, I suppose, with a minority government, is there any hope for Kiwis looking for better citizenship rights in Australia, or for those who perhaps who have had who've been sent back to New Zealand and perhaps don't have much experience of New Zealand, that you might be able to offer some relief?
Well, Australia and New Zealand have always had a very close relationship, and I expect that that will continue, and the contribution of New Zealanders to Australian cultural life is very much celebrated and appreciated. Beyond that, I can't really comment.